Live CDs are useful distributions for testing out new distributions, new versions of Linux, trying out some new software. For example, Exploit Exercises produces ISOs as a way for you to load up these virtual machines and practice pen testing exercises on. And they're just bootable disks, virtually speaking. You don't actually have to install them as operating systems or anything like that. So how do you actually boot a live CD or a live DVD in VMware? Well, to start with, you create a virtual machine as a container to run your disk inside of. So we're going to click Add and New. And then depending on what kind of VMware you have, whether it's Workstation or Fusion, you just want to follow through the normal installation process. So like we'll pick install from disk or image in this case and hit continue. And we'll go ahead and choose the disk image. In my case, virtual machine already knows about the exploit exercises, but if it didn't, we would just click this button here and we would find the one that we wanted to create. So maybe we want to create Protostar this time. We're going to hit continue. And now you have to pick the version of Linux. So when you downloaded the DVD or ISO file, make note of what kind of operating system it is, as specifically as you can. So go back to the website you downloaded it from, or you can just use a generic Linux, like for example, you can use one of these other Linuxes and try to get the DVD running and booted, and then when the ISO boots, just pay attention to what operating system it actually boots to. In this case, we know from the documentation that Exploit Exercises happens to use Ubuntu, so we can safely pick Ubuntu. You can customize the settings if you want, but they're not going to be super important in this case, except for you do want to make sure that in your device summary, you do have a virtual DVD that's accessible by this virtual machine, because you're going to have to put the ISO inside of the DVD, virtually speaking, and boot from the disk. So now we have to load the CD in the tray, if not already loaded. But because we actually chose that ISO when we were setting up the machine, you can think of that ISO as being already loaded into the DVD drive. You can see here that if you wanted to pick a different ISO, you could actually use this same virtual machine to boot to other ISOs just by changing the disk that's in the virtual DVD tray and then booting from that disk. Now you have to have the virtual machine turned off to boot, or you need to put a new ISO in the tray and then reboot. Another thing to watch out for is what your boot order is. So we can see here that the Protostar ISO booted just fine, and now we can log into the operating system and do whatever we want. But one of the settings to watch out for is not only what ISO is in the virtual tray, but what the boot order is. So if we go to settings and go to startup disk, you can see that nothing's really selected here, and the hard disk would always be the default for a virtual machine to boot from. What we can do is we can just go ahead and set the DVD tray as the startup disk and save that setting, and then that way, it'll be more likely that everything will work without any kind of problems.